a patient will often ask me what kind of MS I have. And a lot of people think that we can figure that out by looking at an MRI or looking at their examination. But actually, it's what they're telling us. And so the different types of MS are, there's relapsing-remitting MS, and then there's progressive forms of MS. And this correlates with the different MS disease processes. So the one that we've talked about so far is relapses or inflammation, and that goes with relapsing-remitting MS. So a relapsing-remitting MS patient would tell me that they are pretty steady from day to day, but then at some point they've developed new symptoms that worsen over days to weeks and then get better over days to weeks. And that would be a typical MS relapse. Where a person that has progressive MS, and there's a few different sorts of progressive MS, they have worsening that is just a little bit more steady over months to years. And when we look at a graph of the different sorts of MS, it's really a mix and a match of those two things. So there's people that have relapsing remitting MS, they don't have any worsening in between relapses. There's people with secondary progressive MS, they started out with relapsing remitting, but then they moved on to develop this gradual worsening over time. There's also patients that have primary progressive MS. Those people do not have any relapses, and what happens is just a slow worsening over time that just comes on slowly. There are patients that fall into the MS continuum, but they don't meet the full set of criteria. There's two of those examples specifically. One example would be called radiologically isolated syndrome. Radiologically isolated syndrome means that a patient is found to have on their MRI the lesions that are consistent with MS, but they got that MRI for a completely different reason. So say somebody just has an unrelated fall, or they're part of a study at a hospital, and somebody looks at their MRI and says, this looks like MS. So those patients, we call it radiologically isolated syndrome. Another thing I'll call it to patients is silent MS. And the reason why is because the patient never had any MS symptoms. Most typically, those patients are just monitored over time. If their MRIs change, or if they, of course, develop a symptom, we might treat them. But for the most part, we just watch their MRI and make sure that it's steady. There's another category of patients that do not meet the full set of MS criteria, and those patients are called clinically isolated syndrome patients, or CIS. CIS patients have had one symptom. So they might have an episode of optic neuritis, for instance, or numbness and tingling in their legs. But when we look at their MRI, there's only one lesion or a few lesions, and not enough to meet the full set of criteria to call them relapsing remitting MS. When we have a patient and we've diagnosed them with either having clinically isolated syndrome, relapsing remitting MS, or progressive form of MS, we of course think about their symptoms, and we think about their preferences, and we think about what treatments are indicated for their form of MS. And most of our treatments are indicated for the relapsing forms of MS. That would be clinically isolated syndrome, which is a relapse. They've had a relapse, or the relapsing remitting MS patients. And most of our treatments are targeted towards those. We do have one treatment that also has been shown to work in primary progressive MS. So if a person has primary progressive MS, that treatment we would pick for them.